But today we're doing it from scratch. This is the before.
Why has every song to be about you?
This is the after.
Why has every song to be about you?
Oh, what is up, everybody, and welcome back to another brand new tutorial inside Ableton. Today, we're talking vocals, and more specifically, how to process them. So when you first record vocals and then chuck them into your session, the vocals are gonna sound quiet in comparison with the rest. They're just not gonna like pop in your mix. They're gonna sound just a little bit too, maybe weak just by themselves. So that's where you typically bring in effects like compression, maybe a bit of saturator, reverb to help give them more space and just like blend them into the mix. And all these effects on top of the vocal is typically called the vocal processing chain, and that's what we're going to create inside of Ableton today, just using stock Ableton plugins. So let's get into it. So the vocal we're going to be working with today is definitely not from our vocal pack Saviors, which you can check out in the description. The great thing about this pack is the vocals come dry and they come processed as well.
Why has every song to be about you?
You don't have to worry about like compression effects and all that other good stuff, but today we're doing it from scratch. This is the before.
Why has every song to be about you?
And this should be the after. I deleted the effects. Fucking nice. It's a good thing we got Command Z, ladies and gents. This is the after.
Why has every song to be about you?
So it's a little bit more present. It's got some room. It's got some effects. It's got more character. It's toned out. It's full. It's all those other good words you want to use to describe vocals, you know?
Why has every song to be?
So that's after.
Why has every song to?
And that's before. And you know, you can blend them together.
Why has every?
No, you can't. Phase issues. Fucking 101. Alright, enough chit-chat, let's get into it. The first stage, which is by far the hardest stage, is the de-esser. So if you don't know what the de-esser does, it basically combats like T's and S's and like the sharp sounds like this, which you don't want in your vocal, especially when you're going to compress it later on, because it'll bring up the volume everything, including those sharp S, T's and S's, you know, those sounds. We don't want that, so we fix that with a de-esser. Now there's many ways to de-esser inside of Ableton. There's a de-esser preset inside of the compressor, which...
Why has every song to be about you?
It just takes away a little bit too much character, but that's an option. My favorite way to do it is like creating a custom mapping that just notches out that specific frequency when it happens. So in order to do this, we will need one multiband dynamics, one EQ8. I'm just gonna go ahead and turn off those and maybe keep 6 on. And heading back into the multiband dynamics, so we're gonna select that and press Command G or Control G if you're on Windows. I really hope it's Control G. I've been saying this for like the past year, but I have no clue. One just assumes. So we've got this chain now, and we're going to right click over here, create another chain. So what happens is your main vocal comes through, and then it splits off into two different directions. The bottom one we're going to leave as normal. The top one's going to be our de-esser. All right, so we're just going to solo the de-esser. So we're going to select our de-esser and then solo the high end.
Why is every song to be about you?
So you can kind of hear those sharp S sounds coming through. There's a particular one like right in the middle. There, that song. Right about there. So that's really pronounced, and that's exactly what we're going to be tackling. So this is the tricky part of the whole tutorial. It requires a max audio effect. I possibly think that's an Ableton Suite feature. But what we want is the envelope follower, and we're going to drag that directly after the multiband dynamics. So basically what was set up is a split of this channel. The de-esser is passing through the multiband dynamics. It's soloing, so it's just capturing that high end, and that high end's being passed to the envelope follower, where it's basically following its envelope. So it's just peeking through there. You can like crank the gain as well. So the envelope follower is like mapping the different peaks of the sharp sounds. And what we can do from here is go back into our EQ 6, make sure we've got gain ready. So we left click map, and you should see it starting flash now. And the next mouse click should be on the thing we want it to map to. Yep, that's on the 6th band, and we're gonna click gain. And so if we just play that normally, it's kind of like dancing along to the own beat of the sharp S sounds. So we need to tell the envelope follower what to basically do with the EQ. So its minimum should be 50 and its maximum should be 0. So we're kind of getting the effect that we want. It should stay like roughly around 50. It should be ducking instead of increasing. We had it 100. It would, no, that's not all we want. It would boost the EQ when the sharp S sounds are coming through, and we don't want that, so we want 0. And rise, fall, decay is kind of like your attack and release values. Maybe we can crank up the fall a little bit. And the rise should be like, oh, maybe we should have a little bit of a rise. It should be fairly instantaneous because the sharp S sounds are coming through really quickly. So we want to tackle that really quickly. And what we can do is like move the frequency around for this filter and like find the sweet spot. And we can also adjust the Q to like make it sharper or wider. That's just maybe a little bit too much. Yeah, we could do there. Gain's a little bit too high. And then that's basically your de-esser in a nutshell. We can go back and unsolder this. And now since the DS is basically like a mapping thing, we don't need any audio going through it, so we can mute this channel. I know this might be a little bit hard to like visually map out in your head, but audio comes through here. It splits into two. One goes through the DSer with the sharp high-end frequencies. That gets mapped to the EQ, which is outside the DSer. So when our audio from our normal channel, our chain, comes through, it hits the EQ and then it gets ducked. But our DSer has no audio playing through it.
Why has every song to be about you? Why has every song to be about you?
Alright, so that's our DSer. And we can double click to hide this. So DSer step one tackled. That is the hardest part of this tutorial by far. So yeah, once you got the DSer out of the way, it is primo. So with EQ, funnily enough, that happens to be the next step. So we're going to make the most of this EQ. So we're just going to carve out some low end, maybe dip the mids just a little bit. So how I typically do this is filter one, change that to the high pass.
Why has every song to be about you? Why has every song to be about?
I'd say 100's the sweet spot. You don't Why really need anything below. Anything below that's just like the bottom end of like puh sounds and duh. So you kind of don't really want that. So you just notch that out.
Why has every song to be?
It changes for different vocalists. So feel free to like muck around with that and find the sweet spot for your own vocal. Cool, so we're done that, and next up we're going to turn on filter 3 or whatever and just notch out some mids as well.
Why has every song to be about you?
Crank that with a Q as well.
Why has every song to be about you?
So you're noticing we haven't added anything yet, we haven't like made some crazy boost around Why here. So that's because we're going to boost everything later on. This step's more like sculpting your sound and making it sound primo. Alright, so next up is one of my favorite Ableton plugins ever. It's the Saturator. This just adds a little bit more warmth. We're just gonna honestly bump it up by like...
Why has every song to be about you? Why has every...
Just give it a little bit more warmth, a bit more character. That's literally all we're gonna do. Maybe turn on the DC offset. That's basically the Saturator. Warmth, a little bit more volume, and a little bit more character. Easy. I told you, it's all easy from here on. Next up in the chain is another multiband dynamics plugin. Actually, a standard multiband comp will do just fine.
Why has every song to be?
And this step will help tighten up your vocals a little bit more. And just, yeah, that's basically all there is to say. It'll tighten up your vocals a little bit more. A for like above the threshold ratios and the compression, etc, etc. Have this on loop. And we're just going to change the yellow values, which is the threshold.
Why has every song to be
about you? Deduct a little bit. So we're going to be looking at those blue numbers right here. And I'm kind of wanting like -1 to -3 possibly. All around.
Why has every song to be about you? 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 Why has every song to be about you?
All right, I lied. There's a little bit too much mids, so
why has every
song
to be about you?
Sweet! And that is the multiband dynamics done. The vocals are tight.
Why has every song to be about?
A bit more compressed, a bit more kind of squished. And if that wasn't enough compression for you, we're gonna add some more compression with a glue compressor. Bass punch preset works fine. I just like drag this in and then change a few values, mainly just the attack to make it kind of a little bit stronger, and then the threshold and release to suit the vocals.
Why has every song to be about you? Why has...
So typically my rule of thumb is like 0 to 5. It's just like small compression. We don't want like, why has every... yeah. we don't want that, so we just want like mild compression. So we can just move the threshold to find the sweet spot.
Why has every song to be about you?
And makeup gain essentially just bumps up the volume that we took away through this compressor.
Why has every song to be about you?
Soft clip on, that's probably a good idea. And moving on. Alright, we're nearing the end of our chain now. It is time for some reverb. I like to go for the ballad reverb. Ballad? Ballad. I'm assuming that's right. Ballad reverb. I mean, because everybody wants their vocals to sound like it was recorded in a shower. That's not even a shower, that's like a hall. Not quite what we're after, so we're going to change some of the settings in here. Going to introduce a low cut, turn off that high cut. So the reverb's affecting like the high frequencies of the vocal. Decay time, 3 seconds, it's a little bit too much. We can bump that down to maybe 1-ish. We'll see how it goes, we'll come back to that. And dry wet, of course, we don't want that as 100. We don't want just pure reverb. Maybe one.
Why has every song to be about you? Why
reverb's kind of like personal taste, really. For me.
Why has every song to be about you?
I'm fairly happy with that. It's like not getting in the way too much, not too much reverb. And you can clearly hear like the main vocal, and you can hear the reverb supporting it. Like I said, reverb, personal preference entirely. Nearing the end, the penultimate effect is the ping pong delay. Mental block. I was like, what the fuck am I doing with the ping pong delay? What am I doing with the ping pong delay? I'm actually doing. I'm gonna turn off sync. And then maybe crank that up to 90 seconds. What we're going to do is we're going to go for an old school effect. maybe like 80s and the 90s, when they kind of had like their delay, not necessarily synced to the right tempo of the track, but just kind of like gave it more voices in a way. We're going to try to replicate that. So after we've done the time values and bump that up to 94 milliseconds, we may push that out a little bit more. Feedback, maybe 20%. Let's just hear what this effect is doing right now. Why has every song to be about? So it just gives it more voices, makes it more wider. I'm gonna actually turn that down. Why has every song to be about you? Why has every song to be about you? Why has every song to be? Why has every song to? Just makes it more wider, gives it more voices. It actually makes it sound like it's got more recording vocal takes sitting behind it instead of we're just using like the one audio file. Why has every song to be about you? I really like that effect. It definitely helps like bring it to life. So this is basically our vocal processing chain. The last thing to do is just like add another EQ and do some like final touch-ups with it. And this is where your ear comes into play. If there's like too much mids, too much high end, if you want to boost specific parts, etc., etc. What we had on it before, if we go back to this vocal chain, is just like a little notch in the mids and a little notch in the high end. So we could probably do the same thing. Let's just hear how it sounds. Why is every song to be about? Somehow this low end which we notched out over here has come back to bite us in the ass. That's probably because of the multiband compression and the other compressor. So we can go ahead and notch that out again. Why is every song to be about? Why is every song to be about you? Why is every song to be about you? Why has every song to be about? So those few notches definitely makes it more cleaner, you know, like we're shaping the low end a bit more, maybe adding like a slight boost to the high end. So if you do before, why has every song to be after, about you? It's just real fine adjustments for your final EQ to make sure everything's sitting right and make sure your vocal is clean. I've just like selected all the plugins and then press Command G, Control G to get this into a group. And let's do before. Why has every song to be about you? Why has every song to be about you? So overall, it's compressed. Its enunciation's a lot better. You can hear the details. It's got space. It's got room. It's got that ping pong effect doing bits, making it sound sick. And it's just cleaner. Why has every song to be about? Why has every song to be about? It's just more polished and it's ready for a song. Sweet, so not too bad, right? Apart from that DS, it was probably the hardest step, no doubt. And the rest is mostly just like shaping the vocal and making sure it's like loud enough and compressed enough. All right, so there you have it, a vocal chain inside of Ableton, just using stock standard Ableton effects, maybe minus the envelope follower. I definitely think that's a sweet only feature. Sorry if anybody's using standard or light Ableton. But then again, you can always use the DSer preset for the compressor. Not as good as the envelope follower, but yeah, it's definitely an option there if you want to use that instead. So what's next, I guess? Basically, just build up the rest of your song. Try this vocal processing chain out. You may need to do like maybe a little bit more reverb, a little bit more compression, see how it sits in your mix. You may need to turn it up a bit. You may need to like EQ more mids out. Who knows? Just tailor it to suit your song. But obviously, these exact settings aren't going to necessarily work for your song. So you've got to kind of like adapt this method to your track. All right, that's all from me. If you want to hear more vocals like that and you want to pick up our vocal pack, Saviors will be in the description, of course. Hopefully you learned a thing or two and this can help out with your vocals. See, if you did like it, leave a big thumbs up, check out Saviors, and I will catch you guys in the next tutorial or episode or whatever the fuck we're doing. See ya.